Now, in first problem, diameter of base of cone is 10.5 cm. Diameter is 10.5 cm means radius is half of that, that is equal to 5.25 cm. And slant height is 10 cm. Slant height L, that is 10 cm. We have to find the curved surface area of the cone. We have already seen the curved surface area of the cone is equal to pi r L. Pi is assumed to be pi 22 by 7, means pi is 22 by 7, r is 5.25 and L is 10 cm. So, this is pi r L is curved surface area, pi is 22 by 7, 5.25 that is radius of base and L is slant height. Then you use the 165 square centimeter is the curved surface area of the cone. Curved surface area of the cone is 165 square centimeter. This is problem number first. Again we see diameter of the base of cone 10.5 cm means radius is 10.5 divided by 2, that is 5.25 cm, slant height 10 cm, and curved surface area, that is pi r l, that is pi is 22 by 7, that is to be taken, l is pi r, r is 5.25 and l gives curved surface area 165 square centimeter. Now in second problem, total surface area of a cone is we have to find. Slant height L is 21 cm and diameter of the base is 24 meter. Diameter of base is 24 meter and slant height is 21. Diameter of base of the cone is 24 meter means radius is equal to 12 meter and slant height is given to be 21 meter. Now you know that already we have taken that the total surface area consists of curved surface area, that is pi r l, and area of a base, that is pi r square. Sum is equal to pi r, r plus l, that is total surface area. Pi is assumed to be 22 by 7. R is half of this 24, that is 12. And r plus l, r is 12 and l is 21. That gives the total surface area 1244.57 square meter. 1244.57 square meter is the total surface area. Total surface area equal to pi r square plus pi r l. And if you put all this value, then it gives the total surface area 1244.57 square meter. Now in problem number third. Curved surface area of a cone is 308. Curved surface area 308 means pi r l, that is equal to 300 and l. Out of this pi assumed to be 22 by 7. And its slant height means l is given. L is given to be 14 cm means pi and l is given. So pi and l is given, that is 308 is the total surface area. Total. That is curved surface area. Means pi r l equal to 308. Means 22 by 7 r into this 14, that is equal to 308. Now this r equal to 44 r equal to 30. If you simplify this, then it become 44 r, that is equal to 308, then r equal to 308 divided by 44, that is equal to 7 cm is the radius of base of a cone. Again I am telling you, pi r l equal to 308, out of which pi is equal to 22 by 7, r equal to, we have to find, and l equal to 14. If this cancels 7 and 14, then it becomes 2 in 22, that is equal to 44. This 44 r equal to 308, then r equal to 308 by 44, that is equal to 7 cm is the radius of base of cone. Now total surface area of cone, that is equal to pi r l, that is already given 308 plus pi r square. So we have to find pi r square. So pi r equal to 308 and pi r square, that is equal to 154. Pi r square, that is 154. This sum equal to 462 स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर इज द टोटल सरफेस एरिया, पाई आर स्क्वायर, पाई इक्वल टू 22/7 एंड दिस 7 स्क्वायर, आर स्क्वायर दैट इज 7 स्क्वायर, दैट गिव्स वैल्यू 154. इट इज नॉट 72, इट इज 7 स्क्वायर, दैट गिव्स वैल्यू 154 एंड टोटल सरफेस एरिया बिकम 308 प्लस 154 दैट इज 462 स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर. Now what is given in the problem number 4th, a conical tent 10 meter high and radius of its base is 24 meter. If it is 10 meter and 24 meter, is the radius 10 meter high and 24 meter radius of its base. Now what we have to find, first of all we have to find slant height, then canvas required to make it, if the 1 square meter canvas is 70. Now slant height can be found by using the Pythagoras theorem, because this is h, this is r and this is l and this angle is 90 degree. So what we apply the Pythagoras theorem and l square equal to h square plus r square, h is 10 square plus 24 square, that is 676. So l is equal to square root of 676, that is equal to 26 meter. 26 meter is the slant height. Now canvas required, that is the cut surface area of cone. This is what say canvas required for the tent, that is the cut surface area of a cone. So cut surface area of a cone, that is cut surface area of a tent, that is pi RL. Pi is 22/7, radius that is 24, and L we have already found, that is 26. After doing calculation, we got the area of this canvas required. Now, rate of canvas is 1 square meter, which is 70. So, this much square centimeter canvas required into 70, then what happened? Then it is equal to 1,37,280 rupees canvas required, cost of canvas required. So cost of canvas equal to 1,37,280. How we have find the area of a canvas? Pi R L, using pi R L. And 1 square meter, that cost rupees 70. So this much square centimeter means we have to multiply the canvas area into 70, then it gives 1,37,280 rupees, the cost of canvas. Now what is given in the problem number 3, what length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide will be required to make the conical tent height 8 meter and base radius 6 meter. Assuming that material that will be required after stitching margin all, the cutting and stitching, the 20 centimeter get wasted. Cutting 20 centimeter get wasted. 20 centimeter means it is 20 divided by 100, that is equal to 0.2 meter get wasted. This is what is given in the problem. So what is given in the problem? What is given in the problem? Tent is of height h 8 meter and radius of base 6 meter. So slant height, that is equal to h square plus r square, that is equal to 6 square plus 8 square, that is equal to 36 plus 6400. So L equal to 10. So cut surface area, that is actually the tent canvas required, tarpaulin required for the tent. Pi RL equal to 3.14 into 6 into 10, that is equal to 188.4 square meter. But what happened this is case when after 0.2 meter get wasted, this is what say. So L minus 0.2, that is equal to this 1.884 square meter. So what happened, this L minus, this means out of this canvas 0.2 get wasted, 0.2 meter get So area of sheet equal to curved surface area of a tent into if L is the actual sheet required, then area of sheet required that is equal to curved surface area of a tent into bracket L minus 0.2 that is vested into this 3 meter is the width of the breadth of the tarpaulin that is equal to 188.4. means after cutting this become 188.4. So L minus 0.2 that is equal to 62.8 and L equal to 63 meter. And therefore length of the required tarpaulin should will be 63 meter. Let us take this problem number 6, which is very simple. The slant head and base diameter of the cone are 25 meter and 14 meter respectively. Diameter of base is 14 meter, means radius is 7 meter. Now find the cost of formation. Try by pressing the curved surface area at the rate rupees 210 for 100 m square meter area. We have to use pi equal to 22/7. So curved surface area that is equal to pi RL. Pi is 22/7. R is half of this diameter 7 and H pi R H that is pi R L L equal to 25 meter and it is equal to pi 50 square meter is the area curved surface area and it is to be whitewash at the rate of 210 rupees for 100 square meter. So we have to multiply the given square of the given by 210 and divide it by 100, because 100 square meter that whitewashing cost rupees 210. So 550 multiplied by 210 and divided by 100, that gives rupees 1155. So 1155 is the rate of whitewashing the tomb at the rate of 210 rupees per 100 square meter. 210 per 100 square meter. Now this problem you can do yourself. This problem can you do yourself. So these two problems you do yourself, and that is all. Now do this problem yourself. Also do this problem yourself.